Gurmagath Gerlach, and thank you, Minister, for coming into the House a second time today. We'll be charging you rent next. I want to commend Senator Moynihan and the Labour Group, and I want to support their bill. It is very welcome. It deals with one aspect of the student housing crisis, but it's an important aspect. And the proposal in the bill to restrict the possibility of changing purpose-built student accommodation to short-term lets or short-term holiday lets, I think is one that, and I'm glad the government is supportive of, and I think that it's one that we absolutely need to progress. I suppose I'm a parent of third level students, so I know the demographic very well, warts and all. And I have met with the Union of Students of Ireland. I want to commend them for the work they've done, not just in recent times, but over, actually since the government was formed over a year ago, they've engaged very constructively and government has worked with them and taken on a lot of their suggestions. And I've spoken to third level students from outside of my own constituency in Dublin Central, where, to be honest with you, the last 10 years has been very hard and very galling to see. On the one hand, as others have mentioned, you see new buildings being built to a very high standard and a very high quality, and animating and putting into productive use what were derelict sites. But it is so detached from the local housing need. It is so devoid of any consideration of the local housing need. And it is so out of reach of the students that it is supposed to be serving, that it's really hard to accept it. And something I have complained at length about. The pressures, I suppose, you know, Senator Sherlock mentioned how 20 years ago there was a student housing crisis. There probably was, there was, and I'm not disputing it. I suppose I think what's made it so much worse, actually, this year is, you know, we have an undersupply of housing over the last number of years. We've got the unaffordability of these purpose-built operated ones. And then we've got COVID. So where families would offer digs before because of COVID, that option actually has either been reduced or removed entirely from the market. So that's absolutely compounding the crisis. And I want to welcome, Minister, yourself and the government, what you have done in terms of, you know, the 600 million in rent support payments and the supports directly for students in terms of the increase in the grant, the SUSE grant, and the hardship grants, they're very important. But I also think the work that you've done in terms of the reducing the upfront payments for students, reducing the notice period, the 28 days, that's all really, really important. And the money that you've given to the RTB to ensure the rent caps are actually legally enforced and that the inspections are taking place, the money you've given to the local authorities for inspections. Housing for All will deliver, you know, over the next number of years, and with 20 billion assigned to it and 300,000 homes as a target, absolutely that will deliver. But it's going to take time, and I would call out in Housing for All the commitment that you've given to allow the technical universities to actually use the land available to them to reduce the cost and to deliver not-for-profit purpose-built student accommodation. That's really welcome, and it's really important that we support all of the third level institutions to actually use that facility, to use the facility that's been provided to access funding through the Housing Finance Agency and to actually start to deliver purpose-built student accommodation at a not-for-profit point. But I suppose in the short term, Minister, I do wonder, have you met with the CEO of Dublin City Council? I appreciate that the applications that have been made for the change of use are on a small number of the developments, but whatever number of the developments are, it's an unacceptable number if they're being granted. And have you met with the CEO of Dublin City Council, and can you advise us what he is saying on that? I know the circular was issued, and I think that's really important. The tax treatment was mentioned. I think the tax treatment that was there in place originally required that that the tax treatment would apply if the students came from a list of predefined third level institutions. Is that really being enforced? And can Revenue provide us with that information? And the vacant property tax that this government has committed to that will be delivered through Housing for All, I believe that vacant property tax should apply to any of these purpose-built student accommodations that are priced at a point that are way beyond our own students. And Minister, I don't know if you can speak to that, but I think it would be important. And I just think that in terms of The work that we've done on Housing for All to ensure that the housing needs assessment will be completed by the end of November now for, by each local authority, that housing needs assessment needs to be respected. Manners need to be put on these developers and operators. They need to either reduce their prices and make their properties available, or we need to tax them for that vacancy. It is immoral to have a student housing crisis in our cities that when there are vacant properties, purpose-built vacant properties available to them. I know you've met with Minister Harris as well, and I'd be interested if you could update the House on Minister Harris's initiatives in this respect. Gura Mogadh.